1998, Kolkata. A 16-year-old girl with jet black hair and big curious eyes decided to run away from her village and come to the big city. As she got onto the 3-hour train journey that would take her to Kolkata, she realized that the landscape outside her window changed from paddy fields to tall buildings to factories. Once the train stopped, somebody told her, "Get off, your destination has come." As the girl set her foot on Sialdah station, she was scared, for she found herself completely alone in the sea of people hustling all around. For the first time that day, her heart skipped a beat. She wondered why she decided to leave the familiarity of her village and come to this big city where everyone spoke in unfamiliar languages and walked very fast. That day, she wondered if her dreams were strong enough, if her dreams were powerful enough to actually help her sustain all by herself, without any support from anybody at all. She shuddered and she walked out. And for the first time that day, she set her sight on Kolkata, the city where she still lives. She, of course, is my biggest inspiration ever. And this is her story. A few days after she came to Sialdah station, Jaya found her way to our house. Our neighbor called up and asked if he wanted an extra household helper. My grandmother gladly agreed because my mother had just given birth to my younger sister and an extra pair of hands was always welcome. For the next few years, Jaya stayed in her house like a family member. She was a very hard worker. She cooked well, she cleaned well, and she learned very fast. Jaya had an unquenchable thirst for learning. Initially, it started off by learning the difference between lal mirch and gol mirch. Soon, she graduated to making tacos, nachos and pasta for us. She was also a champion at Jugaad. She started by fixing holes in clothes and got to fixing electronics around the house. Within a few years, not only had she mastered Hindi, the language she had never spoken in her village, but she could also read and write basic English. She was also extremely ambitious and diligent, but we didn't know it then. In 2010, after being an integral part of our life for 22 years, Jaya invited my younger sister and me to her village. We both gladly agreed, absolutely waiting to savor and cherish the simple life of the village. Armed with suitcases full of wet wipes, sanitizer and toilet paper, we made the same train journey back to her village. From tall buildings and factories, the landscape changed to paddy fields. The air became cleaner and so much more crisp. However, nothing could have prepared us for what lay ahead. A two-storied pakka house welcomed us. A car actually came to pick us up from the station. The house also had a dining table, our old dining table, and around it were assorted chairs, one of them without a handle. We also saw our old computer with a few CDs that my mother had given to Jaya. I also saw my mother's old sari, which was being used there as a curtain. In a lot of ways, it felt as if a part of our lives, all those little things that we had given away over the years had been preserved there, given a second life there. And in a way, we could live back and recollect so many of our own childhood memories through all the things that we saw scattered in that house. On the second day, early in the morning, Jaya said, "Today, let's not have a bath by the well water. Let's go to the pond we have." My sister and me made the long walk to the pond. The water was murky, yet cool and refreshing. My sister had just dipped out of the water when we were coming back, wrapped in towels. Suddenly, when the sky was a nice blue and birds were chirping in the air, Jaya told us, "Stop." My sister and me, shivering in our towels, stopped and wondered why we were told to do so. Jaya told us then, in chaste Bengali, "Ekhan theke jotota jayga dekhte pachho shobta amar," which means as you stand here, all the land that you can see belongs to me. We were shocked. Actually, we were shell-shocked. We didn't know what she was saying because what we saw ahead of us was a wide, broad expanse of land. It must have been acres and acres and acres. And Jaya owned all of this? She then explained, "I've been working in your house for the last 22 years. Every month I would save and then invest a part of my salary. Slowly, we started growing crops here. We sold those crops, made some profits, and then again bought more and more land. I didn't know what to think. No fancy startup, no branding, no MBA degree, nothing at all. And yet, just because of her grit and determination, this simple, semi-literate lady from a tiny village in rural West Bengal had managed to create an empire for herself, by herself. Today, in spite of having a lot of backup in the village, Jaya continues to live in our house in Calcutta. She takes care of my grandmother, she serves food to all the little children, the nieces and the nephews who come, and she hugs us every time we see her. When I ask her why she doesn't just want to leave her job and go and stay in the village, she says, "You guys are the only family I know. Where do you want me to go?" She also says that she loves the pace of life in Kolkata and village life is just not for her. Jaya's story is extraordinary because truly it's a story of potential and possibility. It's a story of grit and determination. It's the story of a small girl from a small village with big dreams in her eyes. It's the story of a real underdog who achieved what very, very few people can even consider possible. And that's why Jaya is my inspiration. And each time I get scared, I ask myself this. Imagine that 16-year-old girl at Sialdah Station. If she overcame her fears, what's stopping you? Each time I get tired, I ask myself this. Imagine that 16-year-old girl who's now made this amazing, amazing life for herself. If she could do it, what's stopping you? And each time I want to give up, I ask myself, if Jaya never gave up, why will you?